You've heard a lot about the FNC framework, about its great UI controls, about its different component packs. However, FNC Core is not that much known. And even just with FNC Core, you can do a lot of things for your multi-platform development that you might not have realized. One of these things is downloading content using blocking and non-blocking mechanisms very efficiently. You don't need INDI, you don't need any other HTTP or other communication framework. FNC Core has all of it for all the different platforms. I won't be giving you any theory, I'll be showing examples nonstop. That's the best way to learn, if you ask me. So let's start with downloading binary data from the internet. I prepared a form with a button that allows us to activate the download and an image control, a simple image control from the VCL. This is nothing FNC specific. If you have a FireMonkey application, you might use the FireMonkey image control, or you might also use the FNC image control. It doesn't really matter. The key here is you're downloading binary data. It could also be an executable or something like that. So implementing this is very easy using the TTMS FNC CloudBase class. This class offers very complex downloading mechanisms, but also, and this is really a gem, a method called simple get sync s stream or s string. Let me show you. Downloading a string is very easy using a memory stream, for example. We initialize the stream with nil. We create a TTMS FNC CloudBase class, or we instantiate a class, and then we can use all the methods from LBase. Let me use code completion to show you what's there. First of all, we have very complex stuff with events that can inform you about the progress of the download, which is a request formally. However, what we are going to use is something that starts with simple. As it should be. A download should be simple. It shouldn't be something that takes a lot of time from you as a developer. So that's why TMS chose this great name. So you can say simple get, because it's an HTTP get request. So sorry, post request and something is not something that is covered with these methods. But then you have a choice to make. Either you want it blocking, meaning synchronous, or you want it non-blocking. For that difference, to make it very clear, I'll have an example after this one. Let's start with a synchronous. Synchronous means that the function is called, and then when the result from the internet is retrieved, the next line in your code is being processed. If you use asynchronous methods, that means that the framework, FNC Core in this case, triggers the download and your code immediately goes on being executed. And then you usually have two options. Either you use an event that is being triggered as soon as the data is retrieved from the internet, or you use a closure or an anonymous method. TMS FNC Core in this case gives you the anonymous method for the data to be processed as soon as it has been retrieved. Let's look at the synchronous first, which is much easier. If you have text data, you can use simple get sync as string. It returns a string, you specify the URL. We're going to use simple get sync as stream. You specify the URL, and you get the binary data as a memory stream. As said, the call is blocking, meaning you assign the result of the function to your stream. The stream will also be instantiated for you by simple get. You don't have to call create on your stream. And then you can simply load the data into an image control. For example, here image.picture.loadFromStream and pass in the instance of the stream of, because if there is an exception, we simply free the CloudBase control and the image most likely will never be loaded because at this point the finally will be executed and the click event will be left. So that's why I don't have the check for nil. Even if the URL is invalid, the stream will still be initialized. There just will be no data. That is the difference. So even if the URL that you specify doesn't yield any data, the stream will still be instantiated, so you will never retrieve nil other than some other failure with the method. So this is code you can use in your projects. So basically, it comes down to two lines of code in order to download binary data. Let's run this. So let's click on the button. And there is the image that has been retrieved from the internet. Just for reference, I use httbin, which is a dummy URL service that provides certain data. You can also say image/png, then you can download a PNG image. That is just a service that provides the data that you need for testing. So in this case, we get our binary data, and Delphi, using the tpicture mechanism, is able to load the JPEG image from a stream. Let's test it with a PNG. Let's switch this over to PNG, which is supported as well. Download, and there you go. That's a PNG. Let's expand this example a little bit and make it more complicated, which I've prepared here on the right side. Pretty smart, eh? Hiding the controls on the form. And I want to compare loading the data synchronously and asynchronously. So that you see the difference between these two things that everybody is talking about. And then everybody says, if the one is blocking, the other one is non-blocking. This is a very visual example for you to immediately see the benefits of a asynchronous request. So let's do the synchronous first. And I try moving the form, nothing is happening. Everything is blocked, and as soon as the result is returned, the window jumps to the new position that I dragged it to, and the memo control contains all the data that has been retrieved. Let's look at the asynchronous request in comparison. I request the data, and I can move the form, and I even get an activity indicator that something is going on. And even while moving the form, the data inside of the memo control is being displayed. That is what it means to be non-blocking. Your application is responsive all the time. There is no interruption for the user. And as soon as the data is ready, your user interface updates. That is the behavior that you would like to have, I would assume. So let's look how it's done with FNC Core. First, you have to make sure that the FNC cloud-based control is global for the class that you use it in, because you don't want the instance to be freed or run out of scope without the possibility to free the memory after the data has been retrieved or your application closes. So the easiest thing to do is you define a field in your class in the private section, makes the most sense, and call it fbase, for example, for TTMS FNC cloudbase. And then when the user clicks the asynchronous button, you simply call free on this variable. You might say, how can you do that without actually knowing if it has been instantiated? Well, if you call free on nil, nothing happens. So this only has an effect if you already started an asynchronous request previously and want to abort it and get rid of it. That's the easiest way to do it. You simply say fbase.free, and in case there is something going on, you simply get rid of that. And then you create the new fbase and immediately start the activity indicator. If you haven't looked at the activity indicator yet, it's a brand new control in Delphi, and it is there since, I would say, Windows 10. And the only thing you need to do, you need to set animate to true. As soon as you do that, you get this animation. You also have different indicator types. You have the dots, you have the sector, and you have this sector ring like that. So these are the three options you have, and you have different sizes. You can scale it though as you want. You have predefined sizes, which are defined by Microsoft, because I guess this is just resources being loaded from the operating system. So you have small, medium, large, and extra large. Those are the sizes that are available. There is no position or anything. This thing just does its thing as soon as you set animate to true. So that's what we do in order to basically show that the progress has been started. And when we did that, we call simple get async as string, because this time we want to load text data, example text data. And what we use is something fancy that httbin.org has to offer. They delay the response by 5 seconds, which you can specify here. You can specify a number from 1 to 9 for the delay that you want to incur in order to simulate that the response from the web server is being delayed. And then we have something after specifying the URL, which is called a closure, an anonymous method. And this anonymous method takes the request result as a parameter, and this piece of code, so to speak, is called as soon as your request completes. Completes means that some response has been retrieved. This does not mean that your request was successful, but it means something was retrieved. So for your real world application, you would have to check the request status code, for example, and if it is 404, it means that the resource that you requested is missing. If it is 200, it usually means that it is okay. I skipped all of that. I focused on the most important thing here, meaning because this is something that runs inside of a closure in the background, you want to make sure that you do not call this from a background thread and access your user interface. So what I usually do in this case is I make sure using tthread.queue that the main queue updates the user interface. So using tthread.queue is something rather new in Delphi. Back in the day, you had to define your own thread classes in order to do these things. But tthread.queue allows you to specify a thread class, which is nil in this case, and a closure, which is supposed to be executed on the main thread. So that way you make certain that your user interface is updated from the main thread. I really don't want to get into a discussion about multi-threading. However, just believe me, don't meddle with the user interface from a background thread. And we don't know where simple get async a string is calling this from. So in order to make sure that it is the main thread, use tthread.queue, and then again specify an anonymous method without any actual parameters. And what we do is we update the lines of the memo control with the response. And let's look at the response. So we have a request result dot. And in there we have, for example, result string, which is the result as a string. And the previous example, we used result stream, for example. But here we would use result string and assign it to the text property of the memo control. As soon as that is done, we stop the animation and we also set the free fbase and we set it to nil. That way we prevent it from, that way we clear it from memory as soon as we don't use it anymore. Also, and this is the safety in order to not have a memory leak, when we have a close query, we make sure that we can only close the form when fbase is not assigned. That means all requests have to be handled before the application can close. You could also allow closing the form, but then you have to make sure that you're free fbase and that no requests are going on anymore. But this way you prevent the form from closing when the request is still going on. Let's have a look at this, how complicated this really is. At its core, it's one line of code. You call simple get async as string or as stream, if it is, for example, an image or an executable or any other binary information, pass the URL, and then you need to remember this code for the anonymous method. If you're uncertain how to define an anonymous method in Delphi, you can always look up these types here. TTMS FNC Cloud-Based Request Result Event. That's a mouthful, I agree. So what you do, you try to use Delphi. Sometimes it doesn't work. Find declaration. And then here you can click on the type. Again, find declaration. And there you see, this is a little bit more complicated because it's FNC and it is for multiple platforms. Here, write this is the fingerprint that you need for Delphi: procedure, const, a request result, and so on. And you can simply copy paste it over, insert it here, and you have the fingerprint for your anonymous method. And then in here, you specify what happens as soon as the result is retrieved. And I suggest using tthread.queue as soon as you access the user interface. Of course, there's other possibilities. Some people use tthread.synchronize, also an option. I always recommend books about multi-threading that explain all these differences and how to deal with that in Delphi. As for comparison, to finish off this example, let's look how the synchronous example looks. Literally the same, except we don't need the anonymous method. We only need to call simple get sync a string and then assign it to the memo control. The difference is that even though we set animate to true and animate to false, nothing is being displayed, because as soon as this line is called, this is where your code stays. It's a blocking call. Nothing is being executed, and especially the VCL is blocked from updating the window. So this is exactly the difference between a blocking call and a non-blocking call, or as you often read in the literature, synchronous and asynchronous calls. I hope this example was useful to you to get an impression about synchronous and asynchronous downloads, and you also see how efficient FNC Core is to get the job done. If you want to learn more about FNC Core, go to fnc.tmssoftware.com.